Actress Jemima Oshunde took to her social media yesterday to rant about a man who she claims aggressively chased after her, but who is now engaged to someone else. She further concluded that he was playing games or thought she could have been the one with the ring. This didn't sit well with some Twitter users who have called her a bitter leaf.
So. I beg to disagree.
Yeah.
I don't know so much about Jemima Oshunde. I don't know so much about her, but... if somebody was talking to me, if somebody was, you know, gassing me up with love by February, and then by December, the person is getting married, it's only logical for me to want to ration it out. Okay, hold up. Was this just supposed to be like a game for you? You were gassing me up with so much love by February, December, you're getting married to some chick. So I want to think probably you just wanted to make me another of your side chick. You know, so there was somebody already in the picture, but you just wanted to play your games as a man, which is not impossible. You know, and so for trolls to now come out and tell her that she's bitter, blah, blah, blah. No, I mean, we should stop it.
I dare to differ because love is something that you don't plan. You can meet somebody in 3 months and know that they are the right one for you and get married.
They got married.
Okay.
No.
I'll be the judge, yeah.
Let me just land now. Yeah. A guy that was on your case in February, first of all, a man who is ready to get married, who is done playing and wants to start a family and wants to be with a woman, will go to any extent to make sure he gets the right. So as of February, this guy can be like, he could set a goal for himself that, okay, this is February. By August, I want to have been with a person that I feel I can spend the rest of my life with. Do you understand? And then he tried.
That is what you want. What if the person you want to do this rest of your life with
obviously,
is
this
not
guy
ready,
wants
not
it because by December he's engaged. Do you understand?
Okay, so he wasn't patient enough to wait for if Oshunde was really the one?
She wasn't giving him a positive response.
Okay, hold on. When it comes to being patient, it's not everybody that can hold on so long. I mean, if you want to be with me, know that you want to be with me. And if you're already telling me you don't want to be with me, I mean, it's okay for me to move on. But now, the question is, we're not sure if the guy was dating the person he's getting married to
that's possible.
Do you get it? It's possible. And I think that's where she is coming from, like,
exactly.
Oh, you're playing me. I think people just took out of context.
Exactly.
And they didn't read to understand what exactly she was trying to say. It's not like she's saying somebody should act around that
reason
for
why
10 months.
I understand when you say that people took her out of context, but if you notice, there's this sense of entitlement by women that they feel like, okay, you need to be a bit patient. I can play the hard to get card.
Make it most women.
Most women. No, I said some.
I said some women.
So not even most. Some women have this sense of entitlement, like, okay, you need to wait. I can play the art to get card. If you really want me, try
harder. Do that these days?
Yeah, do you understand? Which is why a lot of people were against Oshunde, because they felt like, okay, if you actually, because the way she sounded right now, she saw him as a potential suitor as well, but wanted to play the art to get card for
him. I'm not sure she saw him as a potential suitor.
So why is she coming out to talk about this? Then she should be happy for him that he's moving on.
People need to... I feel like Nigerians are just really hypocrites, because if not that she's putting this thing out there, is a conversation that I can... Imagine I'm out right now, and I'm telling people that...
In your private circle. Don't bring it on social media.
What if she wants to put it out there? I mean, it's just
because you're trying to make the guy look bad. And then now, people, you know, Twitter people now, they've done their research and found out who this guy is.
Her tweet was very clear. I just feel if Nigerians are not just so quick to attack people, she said, so it's either he really thought that it could have been me with the ring or my finger right now, or he was playing games. So she's just trying
to
say,
isn't
I married to him right now, or he was dating the girl and he was just trying to get down with me?
Well, okay, now that you explained that part, I think that's correct, because she balanced it.
Yeah,
she made just, it look like, yeah, it was well balanced.
Yeah.
She gave two sides of a coin. So
that's what I'm saying. People didn't read to understand what she was saying. Everybody just wanted to, you know, attack any female on Twitter.
No,
that's
because
about marriage
I think it's because we've had series of cases where women are like that and they just come out to attack men for not being patient enough to keep trying. You get, we've had series of cases like that. So they just figured, okay, maybe this is
it's
just
typical
one of those.
People on social media streets not to understand.
Which is why it's not everything
people.
You bring on social media. So I understand where, what's it called, Jemima is coming from. But at the same time, a lot of women should know that this is 2019 and we're getting to 2020 where you need to make your decisions. You need to know what you want out of life.
But they are making their decisions.
The old had to get card doesn't work anymore. Like, because men now know that we have other options. You're not the only ones with options.
And okay, right. I would like to jump in there. Men, if that's the case, now men need to understand that sometimes I can't just meet you and then in 2 months, you are in like a month, you want me to decide if I want to be with you or not. What if I want to be with your friend first and I want to know who you are before I go into a relationship with you? So it's possible.
Well,
I mean, everybody should take their time.
Are we that patient?
I don't know who is making
these
rules or telling people.
Benny,
this is
do you
what
think
you
we're that
do.
Patient these days?
Society is. They created a mold for every one of us to fit
because
in.
Because at the end of the day, this is me and deciding to spend the rest of my life with somebody.
Listen,
I need to take my time.
I'm investing my time and a lot of things. Now, a lot of people will say that, okay, this is a male sense of entitlement as well. So
yes.
I'm going to balance this, that if I'm going to invest my time, my energy, my resources, my financial and all of that into a woman that I believe that I want to spend the rest of my life. And if after like four...
You believe, pretty subjective.
That I believe that I want to spend the rest of my life with. Mm. And if by four months down the line, you're not showing me any sign of seriousness, it's only right for me to feel like, am I wasting my time? And reevaluate. Mm. And if I feel like, okay, my time is being wasted here, my energy, my resources, my everything I'm investing into this to make it work is being wasted, maybe you still give me some sort of attitude like we met just yesterday, obviously, I would move on.
Yeah, that's okay. It's very okay for you to move on at that point. That's what I'm saying. Who makes these rules? Who's telling you to hang on there? Nobody. Who's telling her to answer you in like 2 seconds? Nobody.
But
let
like,
everybody
but I think I'm going to agree with the both of you right now that, okay, our statement was balanced.
Yeah,
it's either it was playing her or he felt that she was the one that should be with the ring.
Yeah.
So on that note, I think we should stop bashing Jemima Oshunde on this one.